Okay, we're going to use Figma like you would use Photoshop. So we're in the canvas here in Figma, and the first thing I'll do is just duplicate this image by hitting click, option, and then shift. I'll select that image, and over on this right panel, I can then edit that image so I can adjust the exposure, the contrast, a number of other items here. You can also crop it, tile it, and a number of other things as well within that image. The next thing that we'll take a look at is adding a specific color to this image. So for instance, I can draw a rectangle and let's just give this some kind of color. And then I can use this layer up here and just use the multiply. And I can come here and use different blending options. Another thing that I can do is I have two images here. And I can also go through here and use the blending options as well to start to manipulate this image. Let's say you only wanted to express the opacity in one specific area of the image. If I have two images here, let's turn this back to normal. I can come here, image, and then go to crop. And let's just crop the person. And then I'm going to reduce the opacity to 25. And that way you could just highlight the opacity of that one image here. And then at any point you can come back and crop this and adjust. I could then also take that different color filter as well if I wanted to have additional highlight that's in a specific color. You can also add a stroke to this if you'd like. And because that's on a blending mode, it's going to still abide by that blending mode there. And let's jump this back up to like 20 so you can kind of adjust the opacity, create this little window. Another way that you can isolate information would be to use masks. So let's take a look at using masks. So I can do this in a couple of ways, but there are some plugins for this, but the manual way would just be to come here and do with the pen tool. And just surround the person for right now. This is just for demonstrational purposes. So I'll just highlight this person and then I can create a fill. I'm not gonna worry about a stroke right now. What I can do is I can select these items and we'll do a Command G or just make this into a group. I can select that group and then I'm actually gonna put this vector to the bottom and then I'm going to create a mask for that. And you'll notice that now I've isolated this individual. And this is really helpful for, isolating specific information. You can then place this on another canvas and you can continue to manipulate the image as well. So let's say I wanted to grab this group. I could put this person back here and then I could, within that group, let's add an image, or sorry, let's add a color. This time let's go blue. Let's do another kind of multiply thing. Let's have that rectangle go inside that group. And then you'll notice that it's only going to impact, that mask is still active just on that blue area. And what's nice about this too, is if you zoom in close enough, you can edit this vector as well. Sometimes it's a little bit hard to actually get the selection. Like right now I'm selecting the rectangle. I'm going to lock that. And I'm going to select this vector. I'm going to lock this image as well. It's making it. And then you can adjust this vector and that's going to adjust the mask as well. Let's just turn off this blue. So yeah, like for instance, if you were to put this, grab this group, put this over here. This just shows it a little bit better how this is working. So yeah, double click and you'll notice that I can now manipulate the mask with using these items and then always going back, you can make that at a higher fidelity as well and add additional points if you need to get a little bit more detailed with that. Okay, so that's selecting the mask. And then another item is also just adding textures to your image. So let's go and move this person back. Let's say I wanted to just add a texture behind this person and not the person itself. So let's just place this texture in the back. We'll move this by using the left bracket, and then I can come to this area and I can just go through these blending modes. Maybe there's something kind of interesting that could kind of help frame and bring attention to this individual. And then also using the opacity here, so you could even do like a 50%. It might be a little bit dark, and then you can go back and actually like adjust this image. So yeah, lots of options to work and play with. So I can come here and then adjust the exposure and just continue layering and adding, both using the layer and layer features, blending modes, as well as isolating things with using that mask option. Those two coupled together, you can start to use Figma like you can use Photoshop. The next example would be adding text. So let's add some text to this image, and we'll just use the T button, and we'll just do guy sitting. And for this, we can adjust the size. And again, what's kind of nice about this is you can take this and you can also use those different blending options to start to explore different options for how you would want to manipulate the text. You can also duplicate it or put it off to the side, and yeah, just have fun with it. You can also add strokes to this, add different effects as well, and start to work with how the text interacts with the image as well. Okay, that's all I got. Hope this was helpful.